Hey, welcome back. When implementing DLP policies in your organization, you must educate users who work with sensitive information as to why some content is protected. And while you want them to stay compliant with your organization policy, you don't want to unnecessarily block them from getting their work done. This is where policy tips can help. My name is Sushant Sutish, and I'm your trainer for this Microsoft 365 certified Security Administrator certification course. After this lesson, you would be able to describe the user experience when a user creates an email that contains sensitive information, and describe the user experience when a user shares content on a SharePoint or OneDrive for Business site that contains sensitive information, and explain the behavior of Word document, Excel spreadsheet, and PowerPoint presentation when a user enters sensitive information as well. So without wasting any more time, let's get into it. Let's start with understanding what are the policy tips in email. When you compose a new email in Outlook on web and Outlook 2013 and later, you will see a policy tip if you add content that matches a rule in a DLP policy that uses policy tips. The policy tip appears at the top of the message about the recipient while the message is being composed. And the policy tips work whether the sensitive information appears in the message body, subject line, or even the message attachment as shown in this example diagram. And if the policy tips are configured to allow override, you can choose show details and click on override as well. But you would have to enter a business justification for the email or report a false positive regarding the policy tip. Please note that when you add sensitive information to an email, there may be latency between when the sensitive information is added and when the policy tip appears. Let's understand the policy tip in SharePoint and OneDrive. When a document on OneDrive for Business site or SharePoint online site matches a rule in a DLP policy that uses policy tips, the policy tips display special icon on the document. If the rule sends a notification about the file, the warning icon appears, and the rule blocks access to the document, the block access icon appears. To show more information and take action on the document, such as overriding the DLP policy or reporting a false positive, you can click on View Policy Tip, and that gives you an ability to choose override or report an issue or as false positive as well. Please note that DLP policies are synced to sites and content is evaluated against them periodically and asynchronously. Therefore, there may be a short delay between the time you create the DLP policy and the time you begin to see the policy tips. And there may be similar delays from when you resolve or override a policy tip to when the icon on the document on the site disappears as well. Let me show you the policy tips in Office 2019. When end users work with sensitive content in the desktop version of Excel, PowerPoint, and Word, policy tips can notify them in real time that the content conflicts with the DLP policy. These Office 2019 desktop programs automatically sync DLP policies directly from Microsoft 365 and then scan your documents to ensure that they don't conflict with your DLP policies and to display policy tips in real time. Depending on how you configure the policy tips in DLP policy, people can choose to simply ignore the policy tip or override the policy with or without business justification or report a false positive. That concludes the lesson on policy tip. In the next video, we're going to do a knowledge check on module 11. So we'll see you on the next one. Till then, take care. Thank you.